Do you know that feeling you get when you realize something you thought you knew is actually way more complex? Well, that happened to me a few months back when I was in the supermarket buying milk. I realized that each carton only had one expiration date, which I know that shouldn't be weird, but it was for me because when I was growing up in New York City, milk had two expiration dates, the normal expiration date set by the manufacturer and the in NYC date, which meant, well, it turns out everyone, including me, had their own explanation for the in NYC date. And of course, we all thought we were right and the majority of us were wrong. The one thing everyone seemed to agree on was there was something different about the New York City milk, and we were probably wrong about that too. Now, I say was because in 2010, the Board of Health voted to drop the NYC sell-by date. And yeah, it did take me a decade to realize that. The point is, the Board of Health first required the second date in 1959. So for 51 years, no one in New York City knew when their milk actually expired. To this day, if you type NYC sell-by date into Google, you'll get news articles from the time with headlines like NYC's milk expiration date mystery, New York City's mystery milk, and finally removing mysterious sell-by date from milk cartons. So yeah, it was a mystery. And when you think about it, it still kind of is. First of all, people still can't agree if the milk in the city actually expires faster. And more importantly, milk, not just in New York, but across the United States, could last a lot longer. In some parts of the world, milk doesn't just have a longer shelf life, but you could store it on the shelf, unrefrigerated, for months. And that's with the same manufacturing processes used in the United States, save for one important difference. This is where the thing you thought you knew becomes way more complex. When I was doing my research about why there are two expiration dates in New York City, I had to let go of a belief I had since I was a kid, which was a bit disorienting, but two words really stood out to me: boxed milk. You see that? That's aseptic, sterile, shelf-stable dairy milk in a grocery store in Germany. And I know what you might be thinking. You can buy boxed milk in most grocery stores in the United States, and you're right. The French company Parlamat has been selling it since 1993. But buying boxed milk for everyday use, that's just not common. I'm willing to bet if you're watching this from the United States, buying milk looks more like this. That's because in the US, there are two main types of pasteurization: HTST, high temperature, short time, and UTH, ultra high temperature. And in the US, which type of pasteurization a milk goes through determines how long it lasts. And the exact temperatures for all this will appear on screen in both Fahrenheit and Celsius. The general philosophy behind high temperature, short time is kill all the bacteria that could be considered harmful, but some bacteria do survive, and those bacteria will spoil the milk. The general philosophy behind ultra-high temperature is kill all bacteria, and that is how it is explained by most milk manufacturing websites. The thing is, if you did that, the milk wouldn't expire, at least not as quickly as refrigerated milk in the US. In practice, it's not that simple. To quote an explainer by Tetra Pak, an international processing and packaging company, absolute sterility cannot be reached or guaranteed. That's because the rate that bacteria die during heat sterilization is a logarithmic function, and logarithmic functions don't reach zero. They can just get really close to it. So you can't just put milk through UHT and say, all right, all the bacteria's gone, it's shelf stable. No, there's still some left. As Tetra Pak puts it, establishing microbiological standards for the end product is necessary in order to develop a viable quality control program. In the US, that would mean a federal standard. Now, I kind of wish I hadn't looked this up, but in the US, there's no standard for expiration dates. They're not required. Manufacturers can add them voluntarily, but unless you live in a state that's imposed its own stricter deadlines, those dates you see on food can tell you about quality, but they have nothing to do with safety. The European Union, on the other hand, requires use-by dates on perishable items, as well as standards for pretty much any food regulation you can think of. There is a global standard for sterile milk established by the United Nations and the World Health Organization, and the European Union details how to achieve that through UTH pasteurization and what commercial sterility looks like in practice. So, shelf-stable milk could exist in the United States, but should it? Putting aside the matter of personal taste, because that brings up some strong opinions, a major consideration is cost. Looking back at 2010, when New York City was getting rid of its mystery date, quotes and comments from articles at the time make it clear that people wanted it gone, not because it was mysterious, but because the shorter the shelf life, the more expensive and wasteful milk was for everyone. People had to buy it more often, and retailers had to throw away more cartons of it. But that was just the case in one city. There is one more component to shelf-stable milk: aseptic packaging. As Tetra Pak puts it, the sterilization process is like steps in a chain that's only as strong as the weakest link in that chain. UHT pasteurization, which is already widespread in the United States, is part of that chain, but they all converge on aseptic packaging. If you look around at milk manufacturing websites in the US, many even acknowledge that their milk would be shelf stable if they were packaged under sterile conditions. But that's just not realistic. Maintaining sterile conditions at manufacturing plants across the U.S., monitoring the concentration of microorganisms that survive the UHT treatment, it's so far from the standards and practices that are currently in place in the U.S. today. So, theoretically, yes, U.S. milk could last longer. But if you don't like the idea of buying milk from a box, don't worry, it probably won't. Special thanks to Sophie Grau for help with my research, translation, the additional footage from Germany, and navigating the very complex world of the German dairy industry.